hear that hissing sound?
What? Yeah, I do.
That means the eater's up. That's the feels like it.
Yeah.
That's always right. Supposed to turn in everything you know about horizontal projectile. You were supposed to have that all figured out. You were supposed to do that twice. After the first time, you were supposed to work with somebody else to make sure that you figured it out. You were supposed to look at yourself to point out anything that was wrong. That was like at the end of last week we did that, right? Like Friday? You were supposed to look at somebody else's.
Yeah,
but
I don't think
we're
gonna
do that. We need to do that? Then we need to do that today.
Okay.
And wait. I think I need to pair you up because you like to pair up with the same people.
No.
For two or three people. you handle getting together with somebody that's not your best buddy? Not necessarily causing problems on purpose, just not the same people all the dang time. You can handle that?
Yeah.
Okay, go for it. There's 11 of you, so there's going to be one group of three. You need to show them what you got. What's your audience? Do you remember the audience? Did you think about the audience when you're putting together what you know? Did I give you an audience in that assignment?
I thought I did.
Talk about
when you say audience.
Assignment detail seven. Think of sixth graders or freshmen.
Oh, yeah.
Hey,
I'm
in here.
Okay, right before you do this, just go back and reread the instructions. And make sure that you're actually following the instructions when you talk to each other.
Yeah.
That would be kind of a big deal. And if you wanted to spread out, get a little farther apart, so you're not talking over each other, that would be fine too. Casey's not in the back, so the whole back is empty.
Is water doing the trick for you, or do you need a cleaner?
I'm gonna work on this tonight.
There's dish soap over here, which is practically the same thing as laundry soap. They're almost exactly the same.
You don't get it out of your mouth.
Can I go with you?
You wouldn't be
did it, so I didn't know what to do. Okay, ask him if we have to have a thing. Whatever he's fucking doing, ask him what we're doing. What are we doing?
You're comparing? You're looking for anything that you think is mathematically incorrect, scientifically incorrect, or age inappropriate.
I think mine is inappropriate.
Why do you have
a ring? Absolutely. Guys? What part of the design cycle are we talking about today?
Oh, my elbow.
Don't do that, it hurts.
What part of the design?
We're talking about Ronnie's elbow.
Are we making a plan?
Oh, wait, no, we're like in the green one. Whatever.
Yeah, I can't read it.
How much bigger does it have to be, Landon?
I'm pretty blind.
Good thing you're not a black receiver, huh?
I can read it, but
right now we're designing.
Have you designed?
No, we're past that. Evaluate and solution.
Implement is to actually build or put together your product.
You can't read the rest of that. Oh, we're modifying.
You're evaluating your solution with each other, and then you modify after you evaluate. So you found something that you didn't think was right with hers, and then she agreed with you, and now she's changing.
That's a lot of reading.
You have evaluated, and now she's modifying. You're all supposed to be doing it. If your product isn't great, you're not doing this right.
I put both hands on. You're slow.
You have each other to help you look at it and see what's not great.
Here, you can
make
it
great. Brittany, did they find anything with yours that needed to be modified?
Probably.
Two people working at yours, don't have any clues on this could be better if? Why didn't you?
Thanks, dude. I'm kind of going to know.
We have different formulas, so.
Did you get the same answer? Well, I know, but
okay.
Do both of the formulas work? Because a lot of times they should have to do stuff. We should be able to drop this next door, and the sixth graders should be able to look at it and say, oh, I can do it now. Not necessarily. No. Why not?
Why anger?
Because we talked about that, because like he was angry in the beginning and then he was hopeful.
Yeah. Why? Even if it's not angry.
He's like really mad at England.
Yeah, he's like really upset. I don't know where you don't get angry out of that, but all right.
Because
he's like angry and like up until like here-ish, and then he's all like hopeful. Yeah, probably went down one. I don't want to go down Fiat.
Isn't that triangle mean delta? Why are they changing?
Sign up for MPI and exploration then.
That's not fun, but it's okay.
I don't
want to
go down
Fiat,
so I don't know why. I don't know. I don't know.
Yes, but you need to denote that. What's that mean? Can you put something in the file name?
Yeah.
Name it number three or
like when you're submitting on for the comment?
No, you can just resubmit, but go do a file save as and put modify in the file name. And then I'll know that you modified it.
Yeah.
five calicos, there's one orange and two white.
Did you keep mine?
Thank you.
Tells me that Tiffany and Demi and Laura and Hannah and Landon have not submitted since January 29th. Working
okay.
On are you still working?
No, I sent my name. Are you still working?
Like, yeah.
I didn't turn it in like a while ago.
You didn't turn it in like the last 4 seconds because I just
recorded. Oh wait, yes I did change mine.
No, okay, I turned it in like 15 minutes ago.
January 29th, 10:56 a.m.
It says it was sent.
Did you turn it in or did you attach it as a comment?
No, I turned it in. I turned it in.
Let me click on Hannah and see what it says.
Is it the projectile motion one?
Yeah. Projectile motion one.
Yeah. We don't have to do this properly.
I only have one submission for
him. Yeah.
Good.
That's what I got. We just had to do an example, yeah. Right?
Nikki has two. Aurora has one.
Hold up. I turned it
Jamie
in.
Jamie has two.
I got this.
Ronnie has two.
Did you get mine?
How come I won't work?
Let me go back down. Hannah, one.
Hold on, I got it.
Cassie,
I turned
two.
It in.
Laddie, too. Landon's still working.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, we're going to do a little design cycle work. Well, something that you guys need to understand and kind of know.
Thank you.
smell the cherries. No, no.
Or like the maybe.
When you thought I was saying maybe something. Mm-hmm.
They're not talking about it, like, huge ass
things. That's what.
You should go to your email. As soon as this little blue light goes over to here.
Alright,
guys. You already
got it? Say the blueprint on it?
Yep, it does.
I got it.
Okay, never mind.
What's mine?
You should open this up.
There's nothing.
You should have everything that I got.
No. Oh, yep. Case.
That's just the title. What was this called? Horizontal motion what?
Projectile
motion. There you go.
Open.
Now.
Where is that? Where's that?
In your email. Well, you can all, even if you're restarting, see it on the wall.
Yeah, I'm going to bow it.
Did you do a brainstorm?
Yeah.
Did you stop and think about, okay, I know this, I know this, I know this?
No.
Or did you just start slamming stuff down on your page?
I thought about
You didn't tell us we had to do a brainstorm, so nobody
did. I know. I didn't require it. But I do know that engineers and artists and all the PhDs that I work for think this up. And one of them has 3 PhDs and the other one has 5 master's degrees. They probably know something.
Good for them.
This might help. This is how they got to where they are. This is why they own businesses.
This is why one of them got to go shake hands with Bill Clinton, because they were getting an award from him,
you know,
and a ginormous grant
so
for like millions of dollars.
She met him at McDonald's.
this one got invited to Washington to stand on the stage with him.
No one cares.
She saved him.
And, yeah, has been to the White House.
McDonald's is better than the White House.
To be on Obama's education forum.
I don't want to talk about it.
Yeah. So, might know something.
Maybe.
Girls, I'm about done ignoring you today. You're going to stop talking now. So, even if I fail to tell you, no matter what, every project or assignment or whatever I give you should start with a brainstorm. You should move on to figuring out how I'm going to build this. How am I going to get done? That is designing a solution. And you should actually make a plan. I am terrible at this. I hate this step. But I also know intellectually that this step is very, very helpful.
Same.
I don't like to do it, but I know it helps me. So if I have an important project, I do it. When I just want to make a coat rack and screw it to the wall, not so much. And then you build, and then you test and evaluate. Did you do any of these steps on this project? Any of the steps that you can see on the screen? Did you actually draw out a design, though? Does that design exist somewhere, or did you just think about it in your head?
I thought about it.
Okay. And a lot of times that's fine. A lot of times that's enough. But sometimes it's not. We just did a test and evaluate.
Yeah.
Now
we built.
And some of you modified. And some of you turned in the exact same thing you had to start with. Which shows very little test and evaluate, and it shows very little modify.
So you're about to say, redo it all, and do everything.
I just asked you to do these two. And then I gave you half the class, 45 minutes to do it. Some of you did. Some of you did it well. Some of you aren't done modifying it. Completely fine. Some of you did a really good job to begin with, so there wasn't a whole lot of modifying to do. That's completely fine also. My point is, you have to put that effort in somewhere. You either have to put that effort into the build and do it great the first time, so that when somebody else looks at it, there's not a lot of things they can find wrong, so that there's not a lot of modifying to do. Or you can do a crappy job and just throw some junk together and get it done on time. And then you test and evaluate, and your modify is going to take a long time. And you're going to have to put that effort in there. Either way, you have to put in the effort. And then the share. I have a guy with the DR in front of his name in Ohio that can look at these for me and compare them to what he gets out of his kids in Ohio, and can tell me, oh yeah, your kids are okay, or, oh my gosh, what are you doing out there? Or maybe he's going to be embarrassed about his kids, and you guys are just completely awesome. Which do you think it's going to be? If you had to pick one of those three, which one would it be?
The first one.
Not so bad?
But we suck.
Pretty okay? Or you suck?
The one that we suck.
The one that you suck?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know that?
Everybody sucks.
Why?
Because you say we do.
No. This right here, that design cycle, that's all I'm doing.
That says we suck.
No, not necessarily.
Everything says we suck. Moving on.
No. It doesn't have to be suck in order to need to be modified. It has to not be completely awesome, and then it has to be modified. Because I think you're capable of completely awesome. If you try, if you give it a darn, if you do some research, if you put in the effort,
you can have something that's pretty darn good. When I look at these, am I going to be impressed or depressed?
Probably depressed until I actually get it.
Probably depressed? If I give you the rest of the class period to go back and modify some more, will I then be impressed?
It depends.
What can we do in the next 45 minutes to make your product impressive? Is there anything I need to do, or you just need time?
Well, you just can say what you can put on there.
I can pull in my crown there.
Okay. That's a good point, Lanny. What has to be in your builds for this to be okay? Or better than okay? Yeah. What things did you have to do that we could write down, that
answer,
we can give you points for?
Answer your question.
Which is?
Like the ski board or something.
Okay. And that was just an example, right? Did you do something similar to that?
Yeah.
Do I need to pop that question up so everybody knows what we're talking about?
Turn it
on. Oh, crowded that one slide. Good to know. Describe or show how to calculate the distance a horizontally launched object lands from its origin. An arrow shot from a rooftop will land farther away than one shot from the ground. Did you do a comparison like that?
No.
Would a comparison like that help a sixth grader or a ninth grader, which is down here at the bottom, right? Would that help those kids understand the concept? A skateboarder, if someone was to skate off a rooftop, their landing spot would change based upon their initial horizontal velocity. What are we talking about there? Can you translate that to guns? If I shoot the same size bullet with a handgun, and with a rifle, are they going to go the same distance?
No.
Why not? They have a longer barrel, and generally the shells are
bigger.
And why is the shell bigger?
There's
more gunpowder, so it has more initial velocity. Right? See what I did there? I took that same idea and I translated it into a different thing, and then you got it. Did you do that? Something for a sixth grader or a ninth grader. If we let a third grader throw a ball as hard as they can, and then we get a Major League Baseball pitcher to throw a ball as hard as they can, one of them's going to go farther again. Even if they both go perfectly horizontal, off the roof of the same building, side by side, same wind, same everything. So how does the initial velocity change the landing spot? There was also a link included. Did you go there?
Yeah.
They ask you to estimate how far he's going to fall. It was 370 meters. Do you know how to do that?
He's going to fall 370 meters.
How far? Where's he going to land?
Far. All depends how fast he's going.
Gee, if only that information was given right here where it says 36 meters per second. This is a silly little demonstration, but it asks you to do the exact same thing I've asked you to do. And when you hit go, you have to actually put in a number. I was off a little, wasn't I? He landed. Put the heck over here. I just put in 1, 2, 3. I didn't do the math. You figure out how far he can go. And you put it in right here.
For what? How do you know how far he's going? Like, it's not telling you.
It tells you his initial velocity, and it tells you how high he is.
Yeah.
You have to calculate how long it takes to fall
You have to separate the vertical and horizontal components, just like we did last time I was here. Just like we did last time in class when I wasn't here. Right? Did you talk about separating the vertical and horizontal components in order to calculate the time? And using the time in order to calculate the horizontal distance? See, this is a part of the brainstorm. I'm helping you figure out what you need to put into your project. And that's what your brainstorm is for. Okay, so you're going to have to go find the formula that calculates both of those things, right? And you have that. It's already in your notes from last time, and it was probably in your problems from before that. Right? Can you use this as an example? I don't know why not. Is there other games that are similar to this?
Probably.
Have those kids ever jumped off of anything? Horizontally?
You can't really jump horizontally if you're going up.
Yeah. What about if you jump off a hay rack? Or off the back end of a pickup?
You're just going down.
Well, you're not really you go pretty much straight down. Sideways and then down. You don't jump down, gravity does the down. You jump straight sideways. Oh, there's two separate components to that jump. They've all jumped off the stage. They probably didn't see how high they could go before they landed. They probably went out and down. Jumped off the bleachers. There's a coat or a book bag or something in the bottom of the bleachers and you have to jump over it. How far do you jump? Do you jump up or do you just jump out? You jump out. How fast do you have to be going? Can you just step? Or do you have to go faster than a step so that you actually fly through the air and then land? They've done that. They've done that before. Right. But their brain has already done the calculations. Because their brain knows if I'm on the third step out in front of the school and I get on the other side of the handrail and I jump off, your brain knows about how long it's going to take before you land.
And why can't we figure out easily? What we can do without even
Well, the human brain is pretty amazing, isn't it? Does these calculations and it doesn't come up and say, oh, it's going to be 8.7 seconds before. But your brain knows how long it's going to be. Your brain knows it's going to be 0.642 seconds. And you step off and your knee doesn't buckle. Or you didn't get your leg all the way straight and then land and jam your knee. Okay? So, if you start doing these things before you go build, you can have a list of stuff that you don't have to go in there. If you have a list of stuff from your brainstorm that you don't have to go in there, you can figure out what order to put them in. That would be a design. And then you go do it. That would be your build. And then you swap with other people and get their opinion. That's your test and evaluate. And then you go fix the things that they pointed out. And then you have an awesome solution. And you might actually know what you're talking about when you get there. Instead of copy and paste some junk and call it good. I know, most of you didn't do that this time. I would say few of you did that this time. But when I looked the first time, there was a whole bunch of that.
And that's what we've been learning how to do.
I know, but you already figured that out. You guys are great at copy and paste. You don't need to work on that anymore.
We take the easy route.
You're great at taking the easy way out too, laddie. I agree. You don't need to practice that anymore. We need to practice this. So, do I need to do anything to help you get where you need to be? Other than what I just did?
No.
You got all the physics? That's no problem. I'm going to shut up, and you're going to finish this in the next half hour, right?
I have a question. Why are you taught everything like the easiest way possible?
Because your brain was not what it is today when you were in second grade.
You're teaching us bad then. Yeah. So
you can't teach second grade the same way you teach 12th grade.
You should. You can't.
No, you can't. It doesn't work. But I do agree that they should do more problems.
There's certain things you have to memorize in second grade, like time statements. And how did you land? You got to memorize that, John. You started in second. You didn't have, you know, 9 times 10, probably.
I still remember fourth grade. Fox and yelling at us. You know,
Third grade was all about math races, right? Flash cards.
That was fourth grade.
Oh, see, we did that in third grade.
Third grade, I didn't know what it was.
We had multiplication and division races. They were all on flash cards. We had to get in two rows. The teacher sat down in front of us and would flip up a card. Whoever won, got to go put a point on the board on their team. Go to the back of the line. And those of you that turned in the same thing twice already, I know you to modify. Not going to be good.
I modified as a body.
I like to change. So you just, have to like read say, it to see what I changed.
I know. That's going to be a pain in my butt. I'm going to have to do that. That probably won't happen until Sunday because I have to go to Math Science Camp. How many people that hate it get up at 5:30 in the morning and drive for an hour to get to school? Not very many. I can make more money working for the contractor in town, cutting boards and pounding nails. This is more better.
Which is pretty much better.
Several people to smile, and everybody actually paid attention when I said that. Which is the point. But when I shift back and forth between chemistry and physics, and big words, and talking like an ignorant redneck, people tend to pay attention when I do that. And that's kind of the goal. You got to get people to pay attention. If it's funny, you'll have to support it. Well, the more effort you put in at the beginning, the less effort it takes to modify. I agree completely. But don't give up. You understand? I can bring in the ninth graders and you can explain it to them?
Yeah, I will.
I think that's going to be a light.
If you're Mr. Moore, he doesn't make money. He's just stupid.
Yeah. He just
lives at a private. I think maybe you just don't understand it. He seems like the nicest guy ever.
Yeah, he's pretty nice. Okay. He can do so much better.
That's something that probably shouldn't be said about people, and maybe could be said about behaviors. Maybe not. Depends if it's a noun or a verb or an adjective. Then maybe the example will work. Laddie, are you being bitchy right now?
No. I agree with you, though.
That one's probably okay. Right. That one is definitely not.
It's okay because she wasn't mine.
Yeah.
I'd be like, you know, and I'm proud.
Everybody's got to have a goal in life.
I know I have a goal right there, but there's a layer. Sorry, if someone's being one, I'll call them out on it, because I know I can do one too. So.
You don't need to do that today, though.
Why don't you get some work? That's all I can plan. With an extra time to work on these, I expect them to be extra good, so they're going to be great and extra hard.
I like
that.
It looks like a
brain,
but it's not.
Hard to get the key.
Your fingernails.
No, I'm trying to stop.
So when I go up here, I'm going to see people looking at clothes.
I actually was really bad.
Because you didn't understand?
Oh, yeah, I was copy and paste and stuff to get it done.
Mm-hmm. And it's like 20
minutes. Yeah, it was.
Yeah, I know, right?
It's not much of a time to do it. But I don't know how to make art into a subscript.
No, it's not there. But if you go to
thank you.
probably won't even get to eat lunch that day.
Have you shown it to somebody else?
Yeah,
but that's just one. Have you shown it to somebody after you
could? You know what? I was on the sideline.
Tony used to do that all the time.
You'd be around for starting all right.
No.
You shouldn't have the same person. You should have a
you just need to know if you can hang it. And I'm sleeping in it.
Running. Keep going, jumping off the cliff. Oh, yeah.
Is that a five?
A five. That's my vertical, and that's my horizontal. That's zero.
A long time ago or something.
Probably right. Camp, like, I don't know what to say.
Tighten it up a little.
I didn't really just got weapon instruction.
I was like, do you sound like if someone asked you, like, something?
I was like, I am not trying to die, but it's not bad. I was like, it's the same, but I feel like it's going to get out
there. Yes, that's the best. She can.
You should love those a perfect skin.
It's like not my place to lie to you guys.
But yeah, she did.
Whatever.
Yeah.
You must have a homework quiz or something today.
That's like the only time I do homework. My mom just said that.